Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And guess what? We're in the, I think it's flysimware Learjet 35A. And this came out a few days ago, and I've already flown it for a few times. And so yeah, I just finished setting it up, so I think it should work. So anyway, so what we'll do is I'll see. Anyway, so I think I've got everything turned on. So anyway, so it's quite simple. I got around without the checklist heaps of times already. So far as I know, this is basically a, what do you call it? It's a pre-release access. So it's like, you know, it's open access, but it's still before it gets to be, you know, kind of finished. So yeah, it's for sale on their website. And yeah, if anyone's interested, I could leave a link in the description, we'll see. But basically, to turn it on, batteries, and that's about it. Oh, the master avionics as well. It does have a tablet you can use for putting fuel and stuff in it. So unfortunately there's no co-pilot as yet. The co-pilot's not showing up, which is really annoying. And so it has a checklist, pre-flight, you know, check everything up, pre-start, oxygen normal, and that kind of thing. So yeah, start up. Optional start, the start. Okay, so it generally pretty easy to start up. I found it not a problem. Oh, I was going to put fuel in it before I forget. So essentially put the fuel in. It will adjust the aft and weight limit. So I think we should be able to do that. I'll leave that the way it is. I think if you add baggage to it, I put a suitcase. So when you go back to your weight and balance, it's still put in there, so that'll do. So yeah, it has shades. They don't seem to want to work, like you notice in the back. Kind of have to open them up to get them to come up. It doesn't sort of thing. And the cabin door, I think the cabin door works, but I won't worry about that now. So anyway, we'll probably use ATC just because I have traffic turned on. So we'll do a quick flight to Melbourne from Launceston, usually where I go. It's usually simple. So we'll just go to land at Tulla. So real basic. So I don't think we do any procedures here. We'll see if we'll do procedures when we get there. But I can. I don't think it'll do. Your arrival would be simply coming in by Warren 8A. As usual, transition to runway 16, which should be that way. So we'll load arrival, which will basically take off. So if I do it out, it should do the correct So it should. Yeah, it's got it pretty much should be like that. So we'll do the procedure and we could probably go onto that sim, but I'm not too sure. I think it's not set up. So anyway, we'll just do the basics. So to start the engine, it's quite simple. You can make sure that they're locked in position. See, they go up like that. So you just make sure they're locked down. And essentially, we'll turn on our lights. So we'll put on it. Don't know which one's recognition, whether at that one. Just check outside. Yeah, it's the let us to know what we're starting up. So essentially that one. And so yeah, starting is quite simple. We'll turn on the inverters and just start. And as you can see, it builds up to around 20%. Mile speeds. Doesn't really give me an M1. I can't find the M1. So yeah. So usually it starts about there. I think that's the M1. I'll do Shift B for the it's quite loud, but hopefully you can hear me still. So I will turn it down a little bit so that I'm not making so I'm not over talking and sounding too loud. So yeah. So essentially that engine now is running with the generator on. We'll start the next one. Start the right side. Trim is kind of, it's on my joystick, so I just pull the nose up and just hold it until it gets to about 4, until the light goes out. Usually it's around 4-ish, between 4 and 6. So I'm not too sure if it's exact science.
Tower 1155, November 145 Alpha Juliet IFR to Melbourne, ready to copy.
1155 November 145 Alpha Juliet is cleared to Melbourne Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 3-2 left climb and maintain 12,000 feet. Departure frequency is 126.5 squawk 4157.
1155, November 145 Alpha Juliet, cleared to Melbourne Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 3-2 left climb and maintain 12,000 feet. Departure on 126.5 squawk 4157.
11:55 November 145 Alpha Juliet readback is correct. Contact ground on 118.7 when ready to taxi.
So,
good day.
Generally, I will set 3-2. So I'll set my bug to 3-2. So we can set that. And we'll set the heading bug the same. We will be joining. It'll probably change when we take off. When I put the autopilot on, and we'll join the circuit. So I don't know if it's going to do the flight plan correctly, because I haven't tried it for a while. So anyway, I think we're ready to go. We'll turn on the other lights. We'll turn on the strobe nav. And that should do it. I think it should be alright.
Ground 11:55, November 145 Alpha Juliet, with Oscar ready to taxi IFR.
11:55, November 145 Alpha Juliet, taxi to and hold short of runway tree 2 left via taxiway Bravo Alpha. Contact tower on 118.7 when ready.
Taxi to and hold short runway tree 2 left, using taxiway Bravo, Alpha, 11:55, November 145, Alpha Juliet.
Okay, so we're taxiing the normal way we normally do. Now, to release the steering on this one, essentially you hit the little steering lock, which will bring that up, and that will open it up. So, tap brake off. Taxi lights are on, then we can taxi. Once it gets moving, it's quite, it's quite quick. So you've got to ride the brakes a lot with it, which is kind of like the way the Mustang used to be when it first came out. I mean, this is like an early access version, so you don't expect it to be massively sorted yet. So yeah, but it's quite good. I mean, the interior still needs work and stuff, but they're planning to updo the graphics, so I'm not complaining. I kind of like it. The seat's been raised since I first flew it, so they've adjusted the seat height, which is better. So steering's a bit, it's okay. It has this kind of radar system, which is generally kind of like that. I'm not too sure about that yet. So the technology is quite old. It's from the 70s, so yeah. I don't expect it to be any. I have the traffic turned on and everything, so that's why I'm using ATC. Otherwise, I wouldn't use it, but I feel like I haven't tried it for a while since I've updated it, so we'll see. Essentially, this should change. So I'll just change that around. Position, which is already at, which is 8, and generally when you log into the plane, it's like that. It's usually set pretty much. You just have to trim it and fill it up and stuff, so it's pretty much done. So we'll just pull up to the threshold and we'll just, I mean, they're very robotic, the ATC. I'm not really down with procedures.
Lowney Tower 1155, November 145 Alpha Juliet at runway tree 2 left, ready for departure IFR to Melbourne.
1155, November 145 Alpha Juliet altimeter 29.80 wind 195 at 5. Cleared for takeoff runway tree 2 left.
Cleared for takeoff runway tree 2 left 1155, November 145 Alpha Juliet.
it is a nice plane to fly. It's quite, how would you put it? Kind of interesting. I mean, it's not like the Honda Jet, the Vision Jet, the Mustang. It's a little bit more quirkier. And it is a business jet, so it's an earlier one. So once you sort out the few little tricks to sort in the autopilot, it's quite fun to fly. And it climbs quite quick, so we're climbing like at almost 200 knots. So, I think we're doing ground speed. Now we're doing 217. So, we'll climb up to 12,000. We'll probably have to go a little bit higher, but we'll see. I mean, I can't wait till it's all finished, till they do it up and put all the stuff in it, eventually, when it gets all fixed. It will be amazing, but yeah, at the moment still early access, so if you want it polished and fixed, then just wait. But if you just want to play with it beforehand, then yeah. I haven't posted a video for a while because I've kind of been doing GCS, and also I'm still flying around the world in the helicopter as well, so I've been doing that quite a bit. I have been recording that because I don't think people are interested in that, so yeah, I kind of can't be bothered.
Flight level 180.
unfortunately, it's doing, because it's on, because I'm doing, in Australia, it's on America, it'll want the transition altitude at 18,000, but I've set it at 10,000, so, which is what you do for Australia. So we're climbing it, just over 200, 230. So, yeah, 277. Which is quite good. So when you get to the cruise, it'll be check normal, what's required, management, monitor, descent, field elevation, five. So yeah, I have to get that information. Probably get told to raise up because it's set differently to their altimeter. So, we're going to be a little bit low. So, we'll see. So, it does follow the GPS and everything, so it's pretty good. I'm not too sure if it'll do an ILS yet because I don't. People say it doesn't, so I'm pretty sure it doesn't have an ILS, so pretty much manual. But you never know. Thank you. fighter jet. Has that fighter jet look about it? So we're doing just about 300 knots now. At 68. Could probably squeeze a little bit more out of it. 290. Down to 10,000 too, because the next one will be 10,000. So I'll set that up. don't know if ATC will let me come down to 10,000 feet before we get there. So we'll see how far we are away. So we're not far. So I've got to come down 1,000 feet a minute. It'll take about 7 minutes. No, 8 minutes to get to 10,000. So we'll see. Cruising 380. I think that's about it. That's tell me to start descending soon. Because there is restrictions, so 10,000 feet. Descending now, so I have to drop it like at least that'd be interesting to see what it does.
Expect vectors visual runway 17 left approach.
asked you to dive down towards the end, and normally you'd be already at 10,000 by now, starting to climb down. So yeah, I'm just
Center, 1155, November 145, Alpha Juliet. Request 8,000 feet.
1155, November 145, Alpha Juliet. Descend and maintain 8,000 feet.
129er.411.55.145.Alpha-Juliet. Goodbye. Melbourne approach 11:55 November 145 Alpha Juliet 8,000 feet.
11:55 November 145 Alpha Juliet Melbourne approach altimeter 29.94 radar contact. Continue to Monty.
So it's now not dropping us down. Sure.
Melbourne approach 11:55 November 145 Alpha Juliet. Request 5,000 feet.
11:55 November 145 Alpha Juliet. Descend and maintain 5,000 feet.
Descend and maintain 5,000 feet. 11:55 November 145 Alpha Juliet. Melbourne approach 1155 November 145 Alpha Juliet. Request 2000 feet.
Rex Tree 767 traffic is 4 o'clock 4 miles at 500 feet Boeing. Report them in sight. 1155 November 145 Alpha Juliet request denied.
That's a bit annoying.
Melbourne departure Qantas 683 is passing 1100 feet, climbing 10,000 feet. Qantas 683 Melbourne departure altimeter to Niner Decimal Niner Tree radar contact. Continue to HORSH. Rex Tree 767 traffic in sight.
5.11.55, November 145 Alpha Juliet.
Cessna Victor Sierra Hotel traffic is 1 o'clock, 4 miles at 1,200 feet. Report them in sight. Melbourne departure, New Zealand 124, is passing 1,900 feet, climbing 9,000 feet. Velocity tree, 27 climb and maintain 15,000 feet. New Zealand 124 Melbourne departure altimeter, 29.9 tree radar contact, continue. New Zealand 124 traffic alert. 5 o'clock, less than 1 mile, 3,000 feet, says the Skyhawk. Report them in sight. New Zealand 124 traffic is 9 o'clock, 4 miles.
Too high.
11:55, November 145, Alpha Juliet, exit runway 1 able.
Generators can come off. Stall warning can come off. The heater heat. As soon as I turn the batteries off, it'll kill it. So pressure is done. Everything is done. Lights. Taxi light. Can come off. And that's it. Oh, I also put the you can put the covers on too, which is quite cute. So you can chucks and covers, and that'll do. Thank you.